Hi, I'm Bill Griffith, an application engineer with Keysight Technologies, and today we're going to look at triggering a dual output power supply, part of the E3640 family of power supplies. The E3640 series of power supplies is made up of single output, dual range power supplies, as well as a dual output power supply. When we program the dual output power supply, it behaves a lot like two of the single output power supplies put together. I'll show you what I mean when we take a look at our demo program. All right, we have a simple example program written in Visual Basic for Excel. So we'll go ahead and start our program, which opens our connection to the power supply and resets the instrument. And then we're going to set up each of the outputs separately. So we've set up the first output with a short delay. It's waiting for a trigger. And we'll set up the second output with a little bit longer delay. And then next, we're going to send a trigger to each of the outputs. So we'll go ahead and do that. Okay, the triggers have been sent. So one output turned on, then the second output turned on. Now we can go ahead and close our connection to the power supply. And we'll go ahead and look at the code underneath our example program. So the first part of our code is the initialization routine. So this opens our connections to the power supply, and we went ahead and sent a reset to the instrument, which affects both outputs. After that, we moved on to setting up the first output, and the way we did that was by using the instrument select output one command. So all the commands after that are used to configure the first output. So we've set it up to output 9 volts on a trigger. We also put the second one in this current trigger. What it does is it sets a current limit. So if we go over that limit, the power supply will go from being a constant voltage power supply to a constant current. So it gives some protection to our DUT. We put a delay in of 1 second on the first output. And then we set up for a bus trigger. So the power supply is initialized and just ready for a trigger. And when it receives that trigger, then it will turn on. We move on and set up the second channel, much like the first, but as you can see, I used a little bit longer delay. I used a 3 second delay, but everything else was the same. Then we go ahead and send the triggers. So the first thing we do is we send a trigger to the, by selecting the first output, we send a trigger. Then we select the second output and send a second trigger. And then we post a message that the triggers are sent. And then finally, we go ahead and close out our connections. So that's the program. And we have one other way to trigger the power supply I want to show you. And so instead of sending a trigger to each of the outputs, what we can do is we can send a single trigger and use coupling. So let's go ahead and take a look at what that looks like. Okay, so I've added the command instrument couple trigger on. And so now what happens is the power supply only needs to receive a single trigger. And when it receives that single trigger, both outputs will turn on at the same time. So we'll go back and run our program with this change made. So we'll reset the power supply. We'll set up channel 1. We'll set up channel 2. And then we'll send our single trigger. And there's a delay, and then both fans turn on. And you'll notice it used the longer delay. And the way it chooses which delay to use is it does it based upon which output is selected when the command is sent to couple the outputs. So let's do it just the opposite way. Let's go ahead and configure the second output first, and then configure the first output. So now the short delay was configured last. So now we'll send our command to couple the channels and then send a trigger. And as you can see, it used the shorter delay. So when you use that coupling, you want to make sure you use it with the setup that you want for both channels. Okay, we've looked at the trigger model for the E3640 series of power supply. And there's really two methods for triggering the outputs. We could trigger each of the outputs independently, or we could couple the outputs, so we sent the trigger, both outputs would turn on at the same time. So I hope you found that interesting, and we'll see you next time.